played the guitar for 24 years. I started when I was 6 and I was studying with my father, who's a classical guitar teacher. At first it was my father's desire to teach me to play the guitar, and then, you know, after a while, really got into it. So I became really excited about it. I started with classical and then I switched to flamenco after about 2 years of playing. And ever since I kind of mixed classical style with flamenco. But I really like jazz and Latin American guitar. And just all kinds of styles. And I believe that if I study a lot of music, you know, eventually it will pay off and I'll create my own style. I have tried to play electric and it's completely different instrument and it has different techniques. And I play with my fingers and electric guitar requires you to play with a pick. And I'm really bad at it. I'm so bad that anybody is better than me. I know a lot of repertoire and I think what is close to me, what I can comprehend and what speaks to me personally. So all my flamenco compositions, for example, I listen to a lot of recordings and then I try to pick, I try to learn whatever I like from recordings. And classical compositions, basically, whatever I hear other players do, and you know, if I really like the composition, I would like to learn it. I don't really know how I pick them. But I guess all the Spanish stuff is close to me, and there are some Baroque pieces that are very close to me, and there are some 20th century composers that I really like. In terms of classical guitar, I really like romantic music like Ponce, Córdoba, or Villalobos. For all of my flamenco compositions, flamenco pieces that I play, I use my ear and I take these compositions from recordings, off the recordings, and I use my ear, and there is no sheet music available for this style. But when I play classical, of course I use sheet music. And I think that's a bigger challenge for me, to use sheet music as opposed to recordings, because when I learn a piece from recording, I can just spend one day and I have it down completely. And then when I use sheet music, just a lot of possibilities available, you know, all the different positions. And I guess classical music is a bigger challenge for me than flamenco. I usually improvise a little bit and my interpretation is completely different from the original. So, you know, flamenco pieces consist of strumming techniques and all the other techniques. You know, if it's strumming, then it's all rhythm. So the rhythmic sections are improvised. And if there are some melodies, you know, like arpeggios, tremolos, and other techniques, I like to keep them as close to the original as possible. There are some flamenco forms, you know, because flamenco is an art, right? And there are different forms of these. For example, there's fandango, there's bolerías, there's granadino, rondeña, and each one has different tonalities and different chords and different rhythms. And for some of these, I have to tune my guitar, but for example, rondeña that I played tonight requires me to tune the 3rd string and the 6th string down, you know, half step and whole step, respectively. There are some new flamenco guitarists, for example, Gerardo Núñez or Vicente Amigo, who like to change their tunings a lot. So sometimes you have to tune like 3 strings or 4 strings to different pitch. And then you have different chords available to you, different sonorities and all that. And it's really fun. I think the future of guitar playing is in tuning. For example, I do compose a little bit, and I found that in standard tuning, I cannot compose my original music because it's just so hard, because all the music that is out there is already composed, and if I start my own thing, it sounds the same. So I like to tune my strings, you know, down or up, and then I have different chords available for me, and they will sound like me, not like somebody else. Saida is actually is married to my teacher, so she is the wife of my teacher. My teacher always told me, you know, you should play with Saida because she sings so well and she plays guitar so well. So I met her a while ago, maybe 7 years ago, and we've been playing together for about 3.5 years. And every time she had a concert somewhere, you know, with another guitarist, for example, because she plays some guitar concertos that require two guitars, I would practice with her. You know, for example, she plays the first part and I play the second part in some of the concertos. So this is how we first started playing together, and we found that we really understand each other, and we love each other's playing. It's so different. And it does take a few months to get to know each other, you know, to understand what our tendencies are like, you know, how do we approach a piece of music. And we also have different ideas about the same piece. So Saida might say something like, you know, I want this section to be a little bit slower and in this tone, you know, this tone color and in this dynamic, and I might not agree with her, but we do play, you know, play a lot, and then we decide, we compromise. It's all about compromise. It's about what speaks to both of us, you know, in the end. And we have the whole composition kind of as a complete, I don't know, story.